So today we're going to talk about some choreography tools. This is choreography clips, so I know that you guys are all asking, what do I use as my choreography tools? Now, this is kind of one of those things that I have a ton of tools that I use, but some of the really basic things I use are simple things like being inspired by what I see around me. So one of the things I love are actually magazines. Now, magazines like this Vogue, right? I can take this and I absolutely am inspired. I'm inspired by the color, I'm inspired by the angle, maybe the intention around the photo, whatever I can see in my mind around this. I'm also in love with this actress, Marion Cotillard, because she is so beautiful and yet so real when she does her acting that I feel like through her eyes, you can really see that she's present. And I think you can see that in this too. Hopefully you guys get a good visual of that. She just brings sort of a presence into photography and film. And I think that's one of the biggest things for performance. When you're trying to work with an athlete or an actor, anybody with performance in mind, you really want to keep that presence and that realness, bring that in. And I think she does a great job of that. So that's one of the things that inspires me about magazines is that you have great, great photography. They're really high-paid, high-skilled photographers. And I might even just grab something and go, okay, how cool is this? How cool is this image? What if this image was moving or became movement art? What would it look like? How would she enter? How would she exit? Something like that. So I get a lot of inspiration from magazines like the Vogue magazine, which I love. Another thing about being inspired when you're doing choreography or having a tool is somewhere to capture your ideas. So I might be out doing errands or running around or, you know, listening to the radio and wow, bang, I got inspired by something. Now what? What do I do with that? So because this happens to me a lot, and I'm sure it'll happen to you guys too, I always keep a place where I can deposit my inspiration and my ideas. So my most recent little fun tool is this little book, which is an awesome little journal, very portable, small, so it fits in my bag. And I love it because it's not lined, so I can put whatever I want in here. There are no rules. That's a big thing for me, no rules. So I love that. There's lots of space, lots of pages. I'm not gonna run out. And so I just opened it up and I decided, all right, I'm gonna put my name in there and what I'm intending for the book and what's gonna inspire me. Then I threw a bunch of fun designs around. And I ended up designing a dress for one of my clients that's getting made right now, super exciting. And I even did like a sort of a mind map when I was deciding what kind of music that I should work with for another client. So it's a great depository for your inspiration. And even sometimes you work through creative issues or problems by having a place to put everything down on paper and not keep it in your head. Now, you might ask, what do I use to write in here? But of course, my favorite thing ever, portable colored pens and pencils. Love it. So, this you're gonna love. It's a roll-up. Check this out. Look at those pencils. So great. Unroll it, and you've got a beautiful set of pencils. Or, you could always take these out and use pens, or felts, or whatever you want. Look at that up close, those beautiful colors. I can take this everywhere with me and design dresses, design programs, design anything I want. Or just record my ideas, my inspiration. And we have a ruler just in case, and it has its own sharpener and eraser. Genius, I love this thing. And quick and easy, let's say I run out of time and I have to get to the next appointment, roll it up, it's got some Velcro right here. You see that? And I throw it in my bag. $5, my friends. $5 at Superstore. So anyways, I absolutely love that kind of stuff. So those are a few of my tips. So first of all, you're never going to know where inspiration comes from. It could come from a magazine, it could come from a movie, it could come from walking down the street. You could get it anywhere. So that's number one, being open. And then, where am I going to put that idea? How am I going to capture it and bring it together so that when I had that good idea, what did I think about that movie? Oh, go to the inspiration and idea book. So couple little tips that I use all the time, and I know you will too.